this is Tony Lloyd. Being a broadcaster for many years, I've witnessed some great stories in the music industry, and now I want to bring as many music stories to you as I can in this series of podcasts. My goal is that they will inspire others making their way in the music world.
Music Stories with Tony Lloyd.
Gareth Dunlop, welcome once again to Music Stories. How are you?
I'm doing good, Tony. Thanks so much for having me back on.
No problem at all. It was a pleasure. I need to find out what you've been up to in the last 12 months, because we did speak about, in fact, it was last May we spoke.
Yeah.
Can't remember what interview number it was, but it was published on May the 15th, 2023. I did check that out. So welcome once again. You are quite an extraordinary musician, songwriter, performer, and so on, and I'm so glad that you're still going.
yeah, they can't keep me down too long. Crazy that's 12 months ago, and it's been a whirlwind of 12 months. I was out on the road with a musical hero of mine, Bonnie Raitt. We toured throughout the UK together.
Wow.
Which was just, there was a couple of real pinch me moments there. I was did a UK run with Lucy Spraggan, been off to the States doing some shows over there in Napa, and North Cali and San Francisco. And last August, me and the guys, we locked ourselves away in the studio and hammered out the new album. And we're almost there. It's almost time for it to go out into the world.
And that's the album, Welcome to the House of I Don't Know.
That's the one, yeah.
What a brilliant title. Why is it that title?
So it is a lyric that is in the first track of the record. The song's called Church. And church is kind of about, to me, almost felt like when it was written, it was the sonic kind of cornerstone of the record that influenced how I wanted the rest of the record to go. And it's really a song about kind of being okay with not knowing what comes after all this. I was dragged, like a lot of people, dragged to church kicking and screaming as a youngster, and hearing all the top hits of, you know, Eternal Damnation and all that stuff. And, you know, faith is such a personal thing, and I never want to be, you know, disparaging to anybody's beliefs. But for me, of late, I've kind of found comfort in living in a land of, well, I don't know. I'm really not sure what happens after all this. And finding, a comfortability in that, and that's what that song kind of speaks of. And Welcome to the House of I Don't Know felt like a good phrase to hang the rest of the songs off for the record.
Well, I think that you and most people will feel like that. In actual fact, you know, and the way, without getting into anything controversial, you know, the way that religion over the centuries has caused so much hurt and wars and everything else, you know, you can understand why people feel that way, you know.
Very much so. It's a, you know, it's a tricky subject to kind of articulate, but yeah, there's no getting away from the fact that, you know, the worst things that people seem to do to each other are justified by belief. You know, it's a tough one.
It is indeed. Your single from that album is called Go Down Swinging. Tell me about that.
So I wrote Go Down Swinging for my daughter Joni. And without getting into too much detail, she'd, like a lot of kids, she'd taken a knock to her confidence. And I wanted to write her something that she could kind of scream out, you know, in the bedroom, and her own little kind of defiant, triumphant anthem. That's the place the song was born from.
Did it work?
Yeah, I think so. You know, I managed to, you know what, it didn't take too much convincing. She was in the music video for the single as well.
And excellent.
I wrote the song. I kind of, in my mind, I knew that I wanted her to be in it in some you know, in some small way, whatever she was comfortable with, whether it was just for a second with her back to the camera. But no, she put her hand up and said, no, I'm going to be the star of this thing, you know. And she aced it. And we had so much fun making the video together for it.
Excellent. And do you think she's going to follow in her father's footsteps music-wise? And do you think that in, say, another 10 years' time, I might be interviewing her?
You know, I don't know. It's one of those things, like, I kind of feel like it would be strange if she didn't, because she's been surrounded by it her whole life. You know, we've had musicians coming and going from the house, you know, since she was born, and I have a studio here at home. So there's instruments and cables and compressors, preamps. There's stuff everywhere. So it would make sense if she fell into it, but, you know, I'll support her whether she wants to, you know, to get on this train or not. You know, I kind of feel like I got into music almost through rebellion. So yeah, we'll see what the future brings.
Well, that's a very good attitude to have about your daughter, I must say. My father was a chartered surveyor, and I know that he always had dreams of me, you know, joining his practice and becoming a chartered surveyor. Two things. One, there's no way I was clever enough to do that. No way. And two, I was always making things with wires and transistors, in fact, valves in those days, and, you know, doing discos and stuff like that when I was a kid. So, you know, it was totally different direction career-wise. But once he realised, then he was very supportive, of course. He never understood what I was doing, ever. But bless him. Okay. Now, I've sort of done things in a different order than I normally do in these interviews, because talking about your career, you've been involved with making music for the series Nashville and Lucifer, I believe, and you've done ads for Disney and Subaru and so on. I mean, they're pretty big clients, aren't they? It's fantastic.
Yeah, I feel, you know, really, really fortunate, really, really lucky to have had those opportunities to write for those shows. And yeah, I mean, there's nothing quite like hearing your work, you know, turn up in something like that. The Nashville series was an incredible one, because it wasn't my voice in it. It was my songs, but they were performed by the cast, which was
Deacon Claiborne.
It was just so mind-blowing to hear, you know, an interpretation of, you know, what a lot of the time was a demo that I'd sent over, you know, for consideration.
Awesome. We, my wife Emma and I binged watched Nashville for weeks and weeks and weeks, and we loved it. Yeah, and the main reason we liked it was because of the music. So thank you.
Yeah, well, yeah, there were a lot of great songwriters writing songs for that show. I'm just glad that I got a few through the door.
Okay, back to the single then, which is the reason you're here. I mustn't forget, which you explained why you wrote it and so on. I think we should have a little listen to it, don't you? Just a little bit, not all, just a bit. Here we go.
Red hair like a morning sun. While there won't be tame, strength and postures imitate, bravery fear can't claim. Sweetness for the sorrowful, light that knows no shade, warmth this cold world's longing for, beauty time won't fade, beauty time won't fade. Make the world work hard to bring you to your knees. Make the road you walk feel the sound of your heels. Make the stars line up when your soul starts singing. And if you ever go down swinging. Go down swinging.
I love that, Gareth. That's amazing. It is really rousing, isn't it? I can picture your daughter singing that in her bedroom at full blast.
Yeah, she got a kick out of it.
Does she know all the lyrics?
She does. She knows them like the back of her hand.
Bless her. That's awesome. If she wasn't so young, then I'd say, come on, put her on and we'll get her to sing it with you.
One of these days, maybe.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, anytime. Now, you're on tour, aren't you, around the UK mostly and a couple in Ireland. So tell me about that.
Yeah, so tour kicks off on the 12th of June and the record's out on the 14th. So the two worlds collide. We are starting off in Liverpool. Then we're 13th, we're in Birmingham. The 14th, we go to Bristol. And then we're in London on the 15th. We go through Sheffield then on the 18th. Manchester on the 19th. Newcastle on the 20th. Glasgow, 22nd. And then we finish off in Belfast here at home on the 28th. And I am I cannot wait to get up there on stage and, you know, stare down the barrel of the microphone and get these songs out on stage, making an almighty racket.
Awesome. I'll have to see if I can get to any. I'm not sure how I'm fixed in June. June's a tricky month for me. But I'm doing a bit of travelling as well towards the end. But if I possibly can, I will, if not, next time. And I would just have to say to our listener of this episode of Music Stories that we're talking about June 2024, because people will be listening to this in years to come and they might get excited about those dates in June. Excellent. Do you find it tiring at all? You're obviously enthusiastic and looking forward to it, but is it hard?
It can be hard. It can be tiring, you know. But you know, I get to go out and play with my friends. You know, I mean, I'm 36 years old, and the fact that I'm saying that sentence, you know, I get to go and play. That's there's a magic to it. That's still, you know, it's never lost on me. So that side of it is still hugely exciting.
Excellent. What advice would you give to somebody listening to this who wants to, you know, who would love to make music for a big music program like Nashville, or, you know, just generally speaking, what advice could you give to somebody listening to this?
You know, it's a tough one. I don't consider myself to be an authority on how to do things right in terms of, you know, the music industry, but certainly some advice that I've been given throughout the years that's kind of helped me keep going is, you know, write stuff that emotionally resonates with you. And if you can do that, there's a damn good chance that it'll resonate with others. And yeah, I mean, fall in love with the process, fall in love with the craft of writing songs, and be okay if you don't get a good song. Opening the door, the possibility of, you know, that there might be, and allowing yourself the time to be creative. And then I kind of believe that everything else is kind of secondary. You know, if you're doing something that you truly love and that you're very, very passionate about, I don't think good or bad comes into it. I think it's just right.
Yeah. Brilliant advice. I love the way that you've combined your passion for music with your love for your daughter as well, with this song. I mean, that's really cool. That's really good. Gareth, thank you so much for talking to me again. Maybe we're going to catch up in another 12 months. That would be really cool. Find out what you've been up to. Your single Go Down Swinging is out now, and your album is, by the time this goes out, Welcome to the House of I Don't Know. I'm looking forward to listening to that as well. All the information will be on your website, GarethDunlop.com, and we'll put that with the text that goes with this episode as well. And you take care of yourself. I'll see you in another 12 months, all right?
Thanks, Tony.
Tony Lloyd, creating audio and film worldwide.